Hey, so welcome. This is going to be extremely long. This is only for those who are really, have the rigor, the grit to sit and watch this whole thing. You can also have it running in the background. Basically, what I'm going to do is put the entire flow out there, about an hour and a half, and just see how that goes. Can we put such long videos out? It's kind of like a background noise. I usually have these YouTube videos on that just keep going. The key nut we want to crack is to do a minimal, high design, kind of industrial design geometry in Gravity Sketch. People do shoes and cars, but this is really hard because it's just continuously alignments, and that's not like a freehand sketching. So really a lot of grid alignments and mirroring. Can we push up D to the limit there? Just but very pure polygon, low poly stuff. Concept phase, early phase, vision and visions of ranges, things like that, volumes. Okay, so that's what this is for. This is not the replacing Rhino. This is not replacing SolidWorks. We're really looking at a niche corner where we can go very rapidly from rough concepts and architectures straight to shooting a movie in Unity in a scene. That's the power that we've seen in the other video, and I want to explore this more for the team so that we can create a flow for our entire design community here and abroad, outside as well, outside of our own community, to explore this. I think there's a lot here. I believe this will be the tool for me to build visions. We did the pavilion, some pieces. We already did some other pieces with some IKEA furniture. There's LiDAR scanning. For me, it's the way to go. And then there will always be Rhino, and there will always be Rafael Correll with IndieGraph, the pure geometry developers who are optimizing, perfecting. This is a niche, it's in the beginning. Let's go and dive in. Hopefully straight to there. Yeah, we have straight lines. So not right now, we're going to just take the inspirational boards, drop them on in concepts. Pencil and just take a step back, do some rough sketches over our kind of like identity, can't see that, there's too much light, identity line work, create some new visions of let's say future potential slimmer type things, which at the moment we don't have the architecture for to inspire, but this is a Gravity Sketch flow exploration. Once we've done that, I will capture it on concepts on the iPad, capture the video, put it together in Premiere as well, and then dive in and rough out those shapes, then go back to the Norwegian cabin, put them in, then import everything into Unity, and then in Unity we will see if we can get some photography and filming going with some different palettes, maybe animate, but animate some cameras, because then you can see how quickly you can go from a very rough kind of flow of just roughing something out in Gravity Sketch to a highly advanced kind of storytelling video. It's not a rendering, it's not, you can create a scene with furniture, put them in, and immediately shoot that video on the wall inside VR, and walk around in VR with it. So this is the flow that I want to show and I want to demonstrate. And let's dive right in. Thank you. And let's rock and roll. So I just wanted to show you video, which is quite surprising to me. But we have video. So here you see the texture that was imported. And I just thought I'd drop it in straight from the image library. And lo and behold, there is video. Let's say drop this in. There's a little interface here to our machine, human machine interface. Anchor it, and now we have. I must make sure that I speak eloquently and not too muffled. But we have video, which I think is really. I've never read that anywhere in the documentation that this is actually possible. So what we're going to do today is to build a few simple geometries like this one. I think I might be actually on the wrong side of it. No, it's mirrored. And explore if we can actually build pure geometry designed for what we do as a print, as an HP design community, as a print community. What we do with our geometry, which is, as you can see, is a very minimal form language. And the purpose of the exercise is to see if indeed we can do things like, let's just drop this in for explanation purposes here. Will it snap to the wall? No, it won't, maybe because it's still anchored. Yeah, there we go. Snaps to the wall. So as you can see, an example of the range, very simple, minimal design, which is mostly pure geometric forms. And then we want to evaluate the tool, and rather than freeform sketching, which obviously is phenomenal in Gravity Sketch, build by means of, let me just delete the video, I'm not going to watch TV. Switch off the person, build by means of very pure, a simple building block to start off with and start building from that. So I want to make a couple of pieces. I wonder if I can move it in a plane. I can, yeah. A couple of pieces and just see where I can get with it. And actually the other one I wanted to do is just a simple Manhattan, because that is a printer that is out today, so we can publish it. And that is very simple and pure, and that is also the basis for a lot of what we do. So I'm just going to drop some of these images in there. Not too many, because I don't want to have a clogged up system. We had fun yesterday, by the way, with the a lot of fun yesterday with the building of a chalet, or kind of like a Norwegian home type thing that we built in our group collab. So let's stick this to the wall a little bigger. Let's just stick this to the wall here. Move this up a little. Stick this to the wall. It's just a fun. So the first thing I like to do is create a studio that makes me happy and most importantly inspired to work with. Inspiring studio. And that's kind of a shitty image, so I don't need that from the website. And then we have coral, which is beauty food. Unlock, snap to wall, and maybe a little smaller. This is just a color reference. I mean, coral is no longer the latest and greatest for this season, but doesn't really matter for now. We want to firstly get the form right. So this guy here was an earlier exploration. As you can see, I also threw some materials on it, because I think you can very quickly get an idea of what it means. This was a kind of a nice joke with the old analog interface. I think it'd be really cool to have something with simple audio interface and dial in there. So I'm going to turn that off. That is, those are all, that's printer concept, and that's tubular bells, and this one can be deleted. Okay, so now we have a very simple basic setup, and of course I want to save that, and I call it save local printers minters Wednesday. I call them minters because that's obviously the future where we want to go. Okay, so first things first, I'm going to make a copy of the block so that I always can go back to it. And let's just first shape the main body. You can, if you wanted to, also obviously just blow this up and have a nice reference directly in scale. Maybe even easier. And that's the beauty of Gravity Sketch. As you can see, I can obviously create, make this layer transparent as well, and locked. And there we go. And go back again. Make it a little larger. Whoops. Hey, I have two shapes over each other. Interesting. I already did that copy thing. Different than what I had intended, apparently, which is okay. So I have two shapes here, which I don't really need. The depth of it, I will simply eyeball a little bit. So it's something like this. It's not essential that this becomes a perfect machine. That's a different color than the inside, so I'm going to now create a copy. Do that wrong, which is so weird. And now what I want to do is from the center, this is again a little bit of a weird thing, create a scaled version. I'm sorry I'm mumbling, I tend to focus on the work and not on the talking, and then I start mumbling, so don't worry. This thing is off center, it's no longer in the middle. Does it matter? No, it is a mirrored thing. So ideally I wanted to, so I'm going to delete that and start over. And here I believe again I've created a double. I'll show you that I created a double. No, I haven't. I always have to check. But yeah, what you can do is do this and go back in time and then you have your surface. This is not a tutorial, although maybe it should be, because otherwise, why am I otherwise recording it? Well, this is an exploration also for the internal team in a HP to walk with me through the steps of creating this. Yeah, we created this really cool Scandinavian cabin yesterday, which I thought was very fun, with KP. So it was me and KP in a space. And the cool thing obviously about that is that KP is in Taiwan in a space somewhere, and I'm here in Seattle, and it really breaks down the barriers of time and space, because it's like you're there, right? It's insane. So if you want, you can already get rid of that stupid giant ball on actually in sketch mode. So on top of there, there's another a very thin plane. I'm actually doing it with different planes, so that this one will be also thinner. And it has to be sketched, because you know, once you drop this in Unity, everything will be fine. So I'm already going to assign a few colors. The gray, the dark gray. And this is kind of a ballpark. And then this one, I want to have that same gray. Let's already pick out a nice. So what I've noticed is that it will actually, yesterday, layers locked, it will suck up color from the pictures, but it will not apply it yet to anything. So let's just go ballpark and a little workable color that we can work with. Okay. Step one, complete. Let's save. I save a lot because I grew up in the time that everything crashed all the time. Okay, unlock that layer. I want to have that one moved. No, I cannot. Leave it. Okay, now the next step is to do the base. The base is also a gray piece, but if you do that and you start laying in some edge loops, it's perhaps better to do the edge loops first. Yeah, I mean, this doesn't even have edge loops. You could literally, what you could do is this. So this one is a panel that is puppy. And this is literally a very thin wall. Oh, it's still mirrored. I need to perhaps break that mirror or just leave it and just make it very thin. Get a little closer. That's the beauty of Gravity Sketch. You can get in real close. And to be honest, I could just go ahead and... Why don't you go ahead? That reminds me. Where's my menu? Where's my menu? Hello? I need a menu. I think I'm... There are these moments in Gravity Sketch when you can become completely lost. I think you have to be here and then go... Oops. And then go again. And now I should have a menu. Hello. Oh, here it is. I'm just trying to find my menu. So I'm streaming this OBS stream straight to my bake mirror. Straight to my... Now what's happening? Now it is a fairly complex surface. So I'm just going to... Now am I... There you go. Delete that. It has no more backing. How would you do that? What I could do is simply just... What? It has been moved. It has been moved. Delete. Why would you delete that? It's not going to be that heavy, is it? Well, I don't want that many. Forget it. Let's just move it there in place. That was the microphone, sorry. And it's already getting too complicated for my needs currently, so that worries me a little bit. So let's go in and quickly finish this off. And yeah, it has too many surfaces. That's the problem. But doesn't really matter. There we go. This is the panel that has the color on it. This does not have the color on it. In fact, you could make that white color like that. Yes. So doing a Manhattan is... Let's say I'm designing a new Manhattan, so I'm obviously going to riff off it, which means this one needs to be a little wider again. So grab all these surfaces. It's so cool to get in there and get that ball to be a little bigger. Am I grabbing surfaces? I guess I am. Something like that. A wall thickness. Same on the other side. Oops, there goes that. There goes that thing again. There's somebody in the house that really takes heating very seriously. Now, obviously, there also is this little thing here. Yeah, I think we need to go a little faster with this. So now the question is, do we radius that? Where is the radius? There's a radius on here, and there's a radius on here. So I'll take one of them, radius it first, this one. And now the problem is, because it's dark, it's hard to work with, so I'm going to first make it light. I'm going to pull it out and first just put those radii on it. To do that, you will drop on here, drop a couple of edge loops, drop on here, and then we will decide how we will make the radius. In this case, I do not want to have our ornamenter, because that bottom part needs to be shrunk. Now, I'm not quite sure yet how I'm going to do this. I'm just going to finagle it so that it looks like a concept in when we go into good old. It's not really yet. In fact, I'm going to do a 45 degree kind of chamfer on here. And what I do notice is that it's actually moving up and down in this dimension. Let's just chamfer it once. And as you will see tonight in Unity, it will all look stunning because this is concept phase. So you have to kind of be a bit bold with this kind of thing. This kind of stuff. Now what we could do is drop one here, and then what we could do is literally move this whole edge. And to select edges, I'm not that good at that yet. I'm selecting this, not the entire edge, right? Okay, so this edge and moving in a bit. This edge, moving in a bit. And remember, it just has to look really good in Unity. So we're not going to go. This is not a Rhino model. This is not a Pro E model. This is just a quick concept model. And exercise. What did I do? Did I do undo? I did do undo. Make sure you realize what you're doing whilst you're doing it. Because, oh, that looks ugly. Hang on. Little issue here. Simply go in and I'm having some tracking issues above my hand. Simply go in and fix that. And fix that. Now, some of these edges are obviously critical, others are not. Let's say this is good enough for now. We have that plum kind of character in there. We move it up to about here. We pull the top surface up. Now remember, this is a problem. So we need to scale the whole thing up a little bit first. And then maybe adjust. Okay, so as soon as I move this, I don't trust it anymore, so I now have a problem. Because what I want to do is select all of the top's surfaces and move them up. So literally like that. Like that. That. And then you're missing a few there, yeah. Okay, that's fine. Let's just do it once. And I'm just going to compensate here by doing edges. There you go. And then I'm going to take the middle surface, smaller ball, and go edges, none of surfaces, and extrude that up. I said that. Extrude that up. I keep doing instead of agree, I click undo, agree is left. So let's say we have this kind of okay-ish. There's an old tray underneath. No, that's the front tray. Yeah, we can pull that out by just dropping a couple of eyeballs. Actually, we can do more than eyeball. But I have the reference image there. So again, this is a lot of mumbling. I apologize for the mumbling. Who was it that said apologize? And dropping this, grab the front tray, too much butter on those trays, and kind of pull it out a little bit. How far? here, edge loop here, edge loop here, remove this kind of at 40°5. Remember, in polygon world, a radius is just a corner. And if you want to be very specific, you want to have a surface on top now that is just that. So what I would do is I go like that. I go like that. And I basically start deleting everything. Occasionally hit things in your room that are finally to find a day where you actually have the flow where you can actually create is for me Mecca. So just having this Thanksgiving to know that there are no meetings and you're not clogged up and you can actually create, because everybody is talking about create, but nobody really understands. You need to take the time to do that. Now I want all these surfaces. So surfaces, again, go back to edit. And I want all of these surfaces to be new. Because if I just take that, that's not good. If I just take an edge and I do switch to edge, I only have that edge. This is a real dilemma for me. How do I extrude this entire surface out without, because I can do this, but then I'm missing pieces on that side. Actually an interesting question. Maybe what I'd do is I'd cut it and mirror it if I could. In another program I would cut it and mirror it. So how do I select all surfaces and then can I have them? Oh yeah, okay, that works. Okay, that works. No, did it again. Select all surfaces and extrude. Hit green and move up. Now we can say, okay, that's going to be the light. Right? And there we have that. It still has that little cut at the bottom also. So that is doable. Again, can I see an inkling of where it is now? Eyeball it. And I think the fear, be not afraid, as our friend Stephen Kaufman says, be not afraid. And now I have a problem because, as you can see, the bottom surface is not cut. So I need to make another cut. Oh, here we go. This is interesting. Delete, start over, or extrude inwards. If I extrude inwards, I'm going to have a problem. What I would do is simply go ahead and hack it anyway. You do not want any overlapping surfaces. So what you could do is simply delete that part and then fix it. As you can see, there's another part that needs to be deleted. And now you can see what problem is here, you see. So what I would do is move that back a little and start fixing these points together, snapping them together. Points must be snap, and that might already have done it. Now I think I moved more stuff downwards. What else did I go downwards? Now that it's screwed. These guys, this edge is screwed. It needs to be moved forward. So this is a fixing job. A little fixing job. And I have no guide.
long.
Back upwards.
And now there's some weird shit going on the bottom still. By means of what I did.
What did you do?
Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah, I see. It's a completely different plane, but it is what it is.
But
you got the picture. And now quickly let's do the top surface. Same color. It's that one. And that one. And save. Alright. Okay, so what we need is a side panel. Side panel is what I would do is this. I would literally take the exact same panel and I would do this. Because this means that everything remains nice and clean. Oh yeah, this is a very complicated surface. Well, why don't we just delete that? Now what we can do is, it's a very complex story. This thing is basically consisting of too much stuff. So what you can do is you delete this. It is kind of fun once you're in there. As an industrial designer, you're really rocking and rolling with it. And it's like you're in some kind of Bauhaus factory of the future. That's the fun part. You continuously have to form these rails. Now we're going to do edge mode. Grab this edge, extrusion. And then you go into points mode again. And you just snap it. And the cool thing is that it's glue, right? It's literally glue. That is the power of Gravity Sketch. It's no longer mirrored, I don't think. Which means we can... Wait. Oh yeah, everything's mirrored, I see. That's interesting. I don't see the things happening here. That's not mirrored yet. So now we have some things mirrored and other things not mirrored. That's a good question how we will deal with that. Well, in this case, I will not be with it. Don't be afraid. Be not afraid, people. The secret... Thankfully, we have the time clock thing. Be not afraid, people. Move that over there. We're not done. Still a little too thick. And the question is, which panel sits in front? I think they did an amazing job on this thing. This thing is just a designer's dream. Very beautiful. I had the privilege to work on this with the team, but I think by no means can I say that my contributions were significant enough to be mentioned. What that does... copy that one, and I'm going to hit something on my table. It's the team that made something amazing here. And as you can see, if you do this meticulously, you get some really crisp flavor going here, which I think is kind of fun. Can I select these two then? Yeah, this is weird. I don't like this. By selecting three edges, I'm not very comfortable with that. But it works. Carson did most of the creative direction with his team at Astro Design. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant people. Now this one needs to obviously, and that was wrong, give me my, you can copy it, because now what I'll do is I'll just kind of mimic that one real quick. Boom. Do I need a top radius? Not even. Oops. Be a little more accurate, please. Thank you very much. Simply move that in and kind of. Let's wrap this sucker up because we're going to make a few more. Just do the top cover. Ah, I have the clock. The clock is on my side. Back up. Ooh. Oh, okay. This is so amazing that you're standing on the shoulders of giants here with your designs. That one is the fakie. There's one fakie in here and then there's one real one in here. How thick is that? A little smaller. Oh! Dang it. You can see I've moved this out of whack. And those are the kind of things you see in the rendering. Shit's out of whack. As a designer. Would be really nice if I could just. Okay, now what we need to do to finagle for this is cut a new display in it. Of course, I'm going to copy this block again. I always have to do that in two. The next session. Let's dive right in. And we have better screening as well. So here we go. We're at Printers World. Minters Wednesday. I think that's where we are. Yeah. Oh. That is weird. Did I just do that? I guess I just did that. We are on this side and we are working on the display. So I think that's where we were. Let's just quickly finish that and then we can also do this. We can also do that. We could make it a little. But now here's the problem, you see, if I scale that, it's no longer center. That I really bugs me. So how do I scale this so that it remains in center? Let's say I put my that's one way to do it. Okay, let's not do that for now. The display, so I need to make a cutout in this piece. Let's move this thin. Let's move both of these forward. And back again. And maybe have this one be forward a little bit more. I think I need to speed up the process because I want to get to concept work here today. So with that, I'll grab this. Oops. Oh hey, that's cool. I can actually see the cuts. So if I make this a transparent part, which is a layer thing. Where am I drawing here? Where's this on? What layer is this on? Interesting. So I have print concept is off. Print world. Yeah, I hate that. So print world goes. Very clear, and it's now I go and do that. And now I can drop these two. Oh, it's actually kind of hard because I don't see what I'm doing. I want to drop a. There you go. Line there and a line there. reflect the whole edge. And you see how you can now move it perfectly. So if you hold this, you can move it. Of course you have to hold it properly, you can move it perfectly. Then, next one will be here. Again, if you hold this, you can move it. Whoa, that's way deeper than I expected, actually. That is way deeper than I expected. That's interesting. And now, another one here, kind of here. Now I need to come up with a way to remove a whole area here to create a. So I think I'm actually going to do it this way. One here, one here. And now I can take this take this surface and move it there. Don't even have to. That creates a really weird surface that is not okay. You need to actually do it differently. And copy it inwards. And now you can turn off the layer opacity. And it's not it, no, it's this one. And now you see you have a surface that is not very healthy. There needs to be some work done. So let's say I pull this up. You can see how weird this surface really is. And we don't want that. We do not want that. This is a very sick puppy. So you have to just maybe delete stuff and see what you have here. Yeah. Okay, now it's clear what we have in our yard. We do have a double. Yeah, I would just connect it to the corners, maybe. Because then we have a fair surface. Even though this edge is not straight, you can make it straight, and there we go. Done. Good enough. Normally we don't say good enough, but now we do, because we're doing a rough cut of this thing. And once we have this one, now the panel needs to have the same cut. So we need to move. There goes my mic. Apologies for the mic. Should be recording, and I'm mumbling. Recording and mumbling. Now what I do is a trick. I create a new layer and make it kind of transparent and drop this guy in there, so I have a transparent front panel. Then let's just make that work. Oops. There's the block, select that. Hello. Edit. And I have a shadow issue now. Now the reason I want to do this is to, for once and for all, get over the. I can't even see it. God damn it. Yeah? I guess we weren't there yet. We were not there yet. I think there's a moment where you will be enlightened into the operations of Gravity Sketch. And I think it's also a little bit pioneering, because I don't see a lot of people trying the full-on insanity that we're trying here. Can I? Oh, you know what? It's a. The surface has two sides to the table. Doesn't matter, all we need is a little bit of something here. A little bit of moving it up. Hopla. And a little bit of moving it down. Well, I don't know where we are with it, so we actually need to look up the other. Okay. that block I would pull out and turn. Kind of cool. I would bake a mirror. And I would delete this front. Delete this. Delete that. Delete this. Delete that. Grab an edge. Extrude. Fix this. Oh, hello. Where's my point snap? Fix this. And create a block like this. And now you can move it in position. Or if you should be so bold. I mean, a nice boolean would be epic now. Let's just create a real quick display here. One there, one there, one there, one there. Again, it's concept, we do not have to go nuts with it. And you could literally move it back. That, and put a picture in it of sorts, or whatever you want to do. And to get radii again, very nasty trick is to just do this, create an angle, angled axis, with 45 axis, and just move it along that axis. And I noticed that it's often going in two axes, which for now isn't a biggie. Create an angled axis, move along that axis. It's really weird because it's not. It's a really weird arbitrary axis. But it's enough for today, and I just wrote over my headset cable. The day headset cables are no longer needed. I shall make a toast to whoever made that. Also, what's this here? It's a tiny bit of something floating around. Okay. Pop it in. And remember, its concept is good enough. I notice there's a lot of good enough is very scary for us designers. Mumbling is what we do. And slurping. This will be edited out. I also notice it's very dark here. I'll up the light a little bit soon. There. I have a light. The joys of working in bloody VR are infinitely amazing. You learn to juggle a lot. Okay. Now, front panel is editable, and we shall make a cut here. And here. There really is something floating around here in front of my face. What was that? Or maybe it is my own. Imagine that's funny. And somewhere here. And then we can simply delete. Really? Yep. And delete. And then all you need to do is fix it. You see it slowly coming alive. It's, hey, the poster layer is, the ref images are not ref. Okay, so now we can select this thing again and make it such and such that it is two at the same time. That's nice. I like that. But not whatever's up there. We're missing one. What the hell? That's weird. What is that one? I might not need that one. What is this? Aha! That's at the top. Jeez. Okay, well then I'll do it differently. This is a critical edge to get right there, right? It definitely needs to be straight. That guy doesn't really matter. You just have to move it along as well. Maybe I cannot fix this. Maybe? Yeah. Yeah, that's good. fix those gaps because you know I have some normals issues or whatever. So let's grab this panel. We're actually going pretty detailed with this one. I'm having some very weird graphics issues here. I see double where there is no double. I see two panels, I think. Oh, okay.
So there you have it. A fix that needs to be made and that you want to do quickly.
But you don't want to mess around too long. So I'll just fix it real ugly. Like that. Same here. Very ugly fix. Very fast. Do not knock your tea over, people, and just and boom. It's not entirely waterproof. You can probably not print this. But hey,
it works.
Boom. I'm grateful for that lamp. That little lumen box is very cool. It's a nice little product. As a product designer, I never say anything nice about products. I hate almost all products, unless they're well designed or well defined. Most software experiences are horrible. They're actually really bad. Okay, and then obviously we can again grab this, pull it out, make a copy, and explode, delete, just delete everything, delete everything, delete everything, hello, delete everything, delete everything, delete everything, everything, delete everything. All I want is to just take the plane. Was not what I thought it was, and then I just have the plane, but I don't even need that, so the edges are going to, this is just going to be a plane to map a display on. Right, I do need a color for that. Why do I get these really old things happening here? Why is that? Oh, interesting, UV. There you go, reflective material. And then the color is just a white, very bright white. Yeah, why is that? You do not have to worry about that. It's going to be a surface in. It's going to be a surface in the. Okay. All we need to do now is the rapid co-creation. Rapid. Something in one box. We got one box to know. And let's go and create the last part. I think that's a little thick. So how does one snap that? So what if you switch snap on? Snap onwards. Grid density 5 cm. That. And then we have the scale of this part. I want to scale according to the center. How do I scale this according to the center? I think it works. I'm lost. This is the kind of stuff that is just mind-blowingly complex. So let's say I want to move all of this down. Well, for now I can't. Let's say I capitulate for the sake of time. I'm just going to do this. And I'm just going to put a line in it somewhere here. Another line here. And there's another one here. And then I'm going to move this one up again.
is just a pure bodge job together to look kind of cool, you know what I mean? Like that. So I have a little bit of surface definition in it. Now, for the next trick, we want that. So we take another block. But we want the radii in it. No, we don't. Take this block, copy there. And let's pause for effect. 2, 3, 4, 5, save. And call that 2. I am from the era where I save too many times. I do realize that. First, we're going to shape it a little bit in shape. And that one goes kind of here. And now, of course, we have the benefit of doing that. So all we need to do now is to grab, if we can, that. Let's move it there to that point. Same here. I don't know exactly where, but somewhere. And then actually, the cool thing is you can actually go to the reference image. Oh, wait, it's way back there, huh? Yeah. Ah, there's a crossover going on here that we don't want. So let's leave it there. And now we're not going by rail anymore. The present rail anymore. So 2 back, 1, 2. And go back to working by rail. So 1. Front 1. A little bit more like that. A little bit more like that. And back 1 goes. No, is it already moved? Back 1 goes. Okay, that's also good. Yeah, I think that's good. And the whole thing goes up a little. No, just this thing. No, just this thing. Smaller bone. Yeah. I want to wrap this up and get to the good stuff, which is making new concepts. And again, let's just grab. This is an industrial design study. I know now I'm going a little. I see it. There it is. There we go. I just want the edge. Oh, you can go in, okay. Got the edge. Over there a little. Go back and call it a day. So that is also part of the dark material. Now what you could do is put it on a layer, right? And my balls spoke the. Maybe you want to create all that on a layer. Layer 1, that's front panels, clear panels. Oh, I'm hitting a nausea moment. Panels. Then I have the next one, which is going to be dark body. And then I have the next one, which is going to be light body. Ensure you keep breathing, because this stuff is stressful like hell, and you usually don't breathe anymore. So you grab the dark body stuff. I'll put in that layer. This is all dark body stuff. Turn that layer off. This is light body. Turn the layer off. Panel. Panel. Dark body. Oh. Layers back. Dark body. That's display layer. This might actually come in at least in something, maybe in Blender, or maybe in light body. Should be it, right? Okay. Back on. So now I want to select everything that's on panels. How do you do that? Well, Now I want to select everything that's on their body and come up with a dark color. Basalt is on the blue side of dark. There it is. And why do you then let go and not let go? I always have these two, I continuously hold these two fingers. You see? That works. And the outside is light body. Which I think is bad, correct? That is that. Light body on. Light body is that. And light body is that. Mm-hmm. All panels on. And we have to now locate, and obviously we want to remove the back, so now we can go to the printable picker. Reference images, and we can move it out of the way. That, and there it is. I think the background currently is a little presets, custom. No, that's not the picture. Not that here. Let's just keep basic for now. Just give me the basic studio, although I would love to have something more groovy. I'm going to go for performance now. And then the light's in the wrong place. So light, just give it a pleasant shadow, and thank you. Light can be discarded again. Okay. Now that we have this, we have a printer that is the same on the back as on the front. So what we need to do, and it's a little too shallow, I can see. You know, it's a little more depth. Look at the picture here, for instance. Right? That's my scale here. It has a little more depth. It has a little. Oh, this is completely wrong. This should be aligned as a whole unit. So this needs to extrude it out. That's better. See, now it's again really hard to do. It's hard to be on the recording all the time. You feel so conscious that you have to hurry up or something like that, but you can't. When you're designing, right, you're mumbling and I'm just not talking. I think talking and working is pretty hard, actually. What I did wrong was the whole thing is too far inwards. There's two ways of going about that. Well, that's it for now. I'd like to fix it, but I need baking everything. So now, for instance, if I do this, create it again, send, and I align it, then I have a problem at the front and at the back. So now what I do is I'd bake it. Let's first save. Save, mint, and let's pause the video because there's a lot of finagling going to be happening now. Okay, let's go. We're building, we have some music, and we may be interrupted by the... one thing I need to do is camera, smooth camera. Can be really annoying for everybody. don't. So I have my sketch imported from Concepts. This, by the way, was the cabin that we made yesterday in the group session. Well, that we built while we were in the group session. So later the cabin will be also imported in Unity. This is very, even in here, this is very unclear and low FPS, so bear with me. This is the other one I just created in Concepts, and then here is the sketch in Concepts. You can blow it up as big as you want, obviously. The nice thing here is that it does tend to scale in this kind of plane, so it doesn't matter. Boom, let's just put it on the ground. I don't really care at the moment how big it is. It's funny. It's actually a decent size. Okay, let's drop this female human on the table here, and you see it's actually not bad at all. So let's keep the human here as a kind of reference. But the cool thing is, so you're in the space, I don't know, this is all spare. This is all spare, but I'm not gonna turn it off because I don't want more layers. And then here's another spare block that I can work with. So, here we go. Maybe I should turn that music off because it's a bit. Barrios classic guitar might not be the most funky tune that we have here. But it's for sure beautiful. Something. I just moved. Oh. Forward in time, backward in time. Backward in time. Hang on. I also have this, which is maybe even cooler. 3, 2, 1, and go. I need to listen to the. Yeah. More appropriate dystopian music for VR. VR is always very dystopian. And this is all about robots. This is kind of the same as well as that. It's over there. Oh boy. Let's not start messing up this geometry now. Let's say I want to create a very simple plane here. That's this one obviously has to be. You're standing in front of this giant sketch wall, which is just uber cool. I mean, look at it. You can basically, yeah, this one's like, this is our, it's like you're climbing a wall, literally. I do have to, yeah, the cabin was cool. So the idea is to just rough out a couple of ideas so that we can try them in Unity as well. There's always a lot you can do in post. That's never what an industrial designer would say. Industrial designer would say, there is nothing you can do in pose. Let's make a copy before we go too far. And drop a shadow for ourselves. So this does have a little bit of a chamfer-ish thingy going on. And let's just move that chamfer and move it inward a little bit, which apparently also moves it upward, which is really annoying. So yeah, we have teenagers downstairs playing on the Wi-Fi, so we hope that I can complete my model without too many. You see, these are the kind of things you see in a render, right? If this is not done right. Those little broken edges are also super valuable, but I don't want to make this too. I have to fix the shadow now because now I'm directly underneath. Go to the light thingy, grab that, and as you can see, shadow is nice, but not. What studio am I in, by the way? We have this, and this, and this, this. Yeah, let's just do this. As long as I can see the I think clearly. Humanoid, you may disappear for now. Your services as a humanoid are not needed. Okay, so let's say there's a plateau on top, or this is repeated, and then we need to figure out some kind of structure. And also a kind of thin bed on top. Ideally, once you have a base structure, you're going to scale it into the three. A little overhang, like a little desk. This is when Harrison Ford figures out that he's himself.
I see things you people wouldn't believe. Attack ships.
It's still a little thin, a little thick over
the asteroid belt.
I see. Attack ships listening over the asteroid belt. I've seen things, okay? So what have you seen? Well, I've seen things. Okay. Well, let's say this goes a little higher. Connects there, and let's say that inner one actually moves better. And I have a very ugly geometry. That is not allowed. And what you just did is not allowed. You need to create another line before you can do that. Let's try that. And then yet again, the triangles are not good. So you have kind of a similar thing going on. And what I would do is already do the drawing, so copy this one. What I absolutely love is this, check this out. Check that out. Isn't that cool? That, my friends, is cool. That, my friends, is cool. Of course, we undo that by means of going back in time. And time. All these cheers listening in time, like what we shall do now is immediately cook up the second one. Oh my god, latency issues. There we go then. See if it's better now. Yeah, seems a little better. I think I fixed something. Let's say this is the second table. It's there. And then let's say I also copy this. And I copy this. Right, let's make a kind of a series out of it. Because we want to see if we can do like range. Range design is the idea here. So meaning, maybe I'm asking too much of the software. Pull. And rails. Hello. I don't see my rails listening to. So if they're too far apart, the rails doesn't work. I always believe a printer should be more like a desk, you know? What just happened? So, there you have it. Apparently, I haven't copied it on the first it's 3D, so you can view things in 3D.
Oh, what?
The oh, there it is. The crazy light should be positioned such that you can see the geometry and go away, green light. No. No, we can go away. I mean, we're just creating something like create tables, like this, right? And mostly, this is not a design. This is a quest for this is a little bit of like game design exploration into so now layers. If you want to do it right, you can. Again, the power of standing here in front of your giant sketch and working to scale is what it's all about. Oh, the door is open. We don't see people. You hear people, you don't see people. In my video. I think I have to be careful because I feel that if I spend the whole day in VR, it might become a little much for me. Okay, so there's a distance at which, beyond which, this no longer works. Okay, it's interesting. Yeah, that needs to be locked. Hello. So whatever layer this is on, can you see layers? Should be locked, right? Okay. Okay. Let's do something with the top surface, or leave it like that. We want it to be a little bit refined, right? It needs to be a little bit more refined. So we have to do something. Active layer is locked. bear reserves where we are. This is range wind, I think. That we're working on. Yeah, we have to come up with a bit of a feed concept, but it needs another day, I think. So let's maybe work on top surface. Hey. Where is that? Where is that? I'm feeling I'm getting exalt mine. Yeah, for legs you really have to think hard as to what that would be right over there. So quick surf. Something's off here. Oh, okay. Thank you. still be a panel? It's kind of silly, but would there still be a panel?
Shreeple.
I think the Shreeple people might agree that there may not be a panel. There should not be a panel. And there will never be a panel. But it's for sake of the exercise, apply a panel and copy that. I gotta go bike, man. Yeah, so there you go. Step one, I think, for today. I gotta call it a day because my head is getting cracked. But when I turn the pictures off, you'll see a very clean fringe appearing. That is, the pictures on, going to be quite nifty. And come up with some feet and some. And yeah, I think success in that sense. We can work our way through this. Or I just need a little break and some air because I really.
Gives me a headache now.
Okay, hopefully the audio is a little better now. So it was a very long video, so thanks for sticking around. For those of you that stick around, it's good to show the whole process so you can look at the little tricks of flow that I'm trying to create. So thanks for hanging around. And there will be next episode. I will just start cleaning things up, building a very simple three-row concept type thing with some funky stuff in it, taking it out of Gravity Sketch, maybe into Blender to do some UV unwrap, otherwise straight FBX as well into Unity. And then once we create that studio, well, we have a studio, drop it in and see what we can do, see if it becomes useful to immediately do some video shoots there. So yeah, it's super long video, but worth it, maybe for some. Maybe. And I think for us, as a design team, we need to make the decision, is this the tool for us or not? So this is the only way to figure it out, is to actually go in and make some very pure and simple geometry. I think it has a place in concept, very early rough concept phase. We don't do that often very often anymore. We tend to dive in with maybe some sketches and then go into CAD, Rhino, or SolidWorks, things like that. There's some of us that do more exploration, but I think we need to revive a little bit that vision concept work where we also drive architectures and actually drive roadmaps. And this will be a useful tool because now we can combine the environments in Unity with VR, with new quick concepts, so that speeds up that whole flow, that discovery phase in the beginning. So yeah, with that, till next time after Thanksgiving. This is the Thanksgiving show of Wednesday the 24th, and there will be more coming as we mature our virtual reality movie studios for design reviews. Okay, with that, thank you very much.